much for giving us the time. Actually, we have a bird bread with us to show you what we are doing right now. So the patient is a paroxysmal AFib. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can.
Fantastic. So, okay.
Hold on 1 second. So just to make sure everyone is following here. So the first case you were doing, you're still working on it on
another room. We are still working on AFib.
What you're showing us
now
is a second case using what it looks like a laser balloon.
Yes, absolutely. Okay. You are right. Very correct. So actually, can you focus the camera on the two balloons? There are the demos of two balloons. Actually, the original balloon is on the right side from your vision, and actually this is a FDA approved balloon. So actually this system is FDA approved since April 2016. We are now using much more softer and much more compliant balloon, which hopefully override all this criticism about antral or ostial lesions. So with this kind of balloon we are using now in this patient, we did first 6 patients in the world. Actually, so 6 patients are done right now, and this is the next one. And we hope that we can show you how far away from PV we can use the laser. And Musa, you are very familiar with the laser as you were part of the study. So actually you can appreciate yourself what we can show you right now.
If you can show us on air a vein, one vein isolation.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah. So Peter, okay. let me just make a comment while you're doing this.
Well, let's start with ablation.
Just for the audience.
Let's start with ablation. Okay, go. Okay,
so just for the audience.
Yes.
You notice that there's a lot more, let's say, interaction between the balloon and the tissue. So at least compared to what we were used to, where you had oftentimes fleeting contact at certain locations or intermittent contact, our observations with this balloon, at least again, it's early observations. As Peter said, this is only the 6th case with this balloon. But our early observations are that we have a greater amount of contact, hence allowing one to place the lesion, and also using higher power, by the way. Using high power, this is 12,
using
10 watts of energy.
So he's using 10 watts now, and for 20 seconds.
We are going to 12. We are going to 12.
And for the audience, the green flashing light is where the laser beam is being applied.
The fluoro, Peter?
Yes. you cannot. You haven't seen that?
Well, we can't see the fluoro. Okay, now we see it.
Okay.
So we're still a little bit away. From the esophagus, at least from the esophagus.
But you know that even we are like 1 centimeter away, you can still heat, okay?
How much bigger is the this new balloon versus the old?
The overall balloon size is not that much different.
Just the compliance.
Yeah, it's just the compliance is more is better
actually,
to allow better apposition.
We have a question from Dr. Packer.
One additional question is, I'm actually quite surprised at the difference in this appearance compared to what we've been using. So, you know, we've been talking about more compliant balloons forever.
Forever.
And so now you have one. It fits better. So the question that I have is, wouldn't this lend itself a bit more readily to a bigger arc?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's a good question.
It's a good question.
It allows different possibilities. One is a bigger arc. A second is even higher power for shorter duration. You can imagine 16 watts for 10 seconds or 5 seconds. There's a lot of different possibilities. But make these two lesions and then rotate the balloon. I think people
Absolutely.
Would like
we
to
will
see
show you
how
rotational
that looks.
Principle because, you know, we still need to stress that the shaft of the balloon is not idle to lay. So actually, we are not confident to lace under the shaft, okay? So I will rotate the balloon right now to show you which way I can deal with that, okay? So you can see even this small maneuvers, I can really get very nice part of carina in between upper, which is upper on the image, and carina and the left inferior, which is occluded. So now we continue the lesion on the carina, and we need to have like maybe like 3 lesions more to isolate, okay?
The typical practice is to go to all 4 veins, make circumferential lesions, and because there's a high rate of first pass isolation, then what you can do is at the very end go in with the last one, verify that the veins are isolated. Can you show us electrograms?
Look, it's perfect. It's a independent potential. Look at that. So we are...
We can't see it.
Can
Peter,
we
can't
can
see it.
Pruka, can you show us Pruka Live?
Okay.
Pruka Live, please.
Okay.
Okay. Once again,
we have two dissociated potential.
Absolutely.
That's probably no. This is dissociated potential, yeah.
Yes.
So what
are you
we're
happy?
Seeing here is we have a circular mapping catheter in the vein, and we see dissociated PV potential. You know, obviously indicating entrance and exit block for the vein. The whole vein was done in one rotational circle of ablation. It's very nice results.